In this last episode of our four-part series on Python and Django on Azure, Carlton Gibson is here to show us how you can run Python apps with Django in a serverless way using Visual Studio Code and Azure Functions today on Azure Friday. Friends and Pythonistas, welcome to Azure Fridays. I'm Nina Zakharenko, a senior cloud developer advocate at Microsoft. Here with me today is Carlton Gibson. He's a Django fellow, as well as a maintainer of Django, Django REST frameworks, and a lot of other packages that you've probably heard of. In the last few episodes, we've been talking about how to develop a Django application with VS Code and deploy it to Azure App Service. Today, we're going to talk about a very popular topic, serverless. Carlton?
OK, brilliant. Thank you, Nina. So the Microsoft Azure serverless offering is called Functions. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is go back to VS Code, and we're going to have the Functions extension. And this enables us to create new Functions apps. If we pull up the command, we can and we type in Functions, we can create a new function, create a new project, Functions project, we can do all the things. I've already got a Functions project created here. I've already initialized it, but you can initialize your project in VS Code and it will run through all that for you.
Excellent.
And that's good. What we're going to show you, what I'm going to do though, let's create a new, let's create a function, okay? Select the folder, okay, bam, and select a function transport. Well, let's use the HTTP trigger because, you know, with Django nuts. Provide a function name, well, let's just call it HTTP trigger, fine. And let's go anonymous. Brilliant. Okay. Wow, and this created this code for us.
So very quickly, what is a HTTP trigger function?
Okay, so that it basically what it does is it creates a web endpoint which will take a web request and it will return a web response.
Great, pretty simple. You.
Yeah, pretty simple. So we can see that going on here. The function, the bit here, is this main function, and you can see here it takes in a function HTTP request and it returns a function HTTP response. Okay, so it takes the request here, has all the things we get, like parameters, which you'll get from the query string. It says a name. If you don't enter a name, it will say, please pass a name. So, you know, it's a standard thing. Let's just have a look at it. So we can open it up in the shell. Let's just run it locally.
So there you just typed in func host start.
Yeah, which is the command line tool. And if you wanted to, you could do this. You could run a task, and there's you can run your functions host using the tasks command, which you can also get to from the terminal.
Great, it's always great having options.
Yeah. So this is up and running, and this is what we just created. And so it's doing some things in here. Right, let's have a look. Oh, pass a name on the in the query string or the request body. So let's put a name in. Name equals Nina, bam. We said, hello, Nina.
Hello, Azure Function.
Well, there you are, right. OK, so that's the basics. Let's do something more interesting. So let me quit this, stop the interpreter there. And then let me just go to the debug activity panel here. And we select this attach to Python functions option. And we'll start that up. And while that's starting up, I'll talk you through what we've got. Let's hide that. OK, so we come to the code, and if we close this one. And our function is in serverless. And where this one that was created is very simple, ours is a little bit different. So let's look down here at our function. Again, it's the main function there. It takes in a function HTTP request, and it returns an HTTP response. Okay, and that response we get from this Azure application object here, which is an Azure WSGI handler.
Okay.
Now, what's WSGI? WSGI is the Python standard for web server application frameworks. So it stands for web server gateway interface. It's like Common Gateway Interface, CGI of old. And the great thing about WSGI is all the Python web frameworks use it. So Django serves WSGI, is a WSGI application. Flask, Zone, all of them.
Yes.
They're all WSGI. So if we can use a WSGI application in Functions, then we can use any Python web framework in Functions. That's the goal here. Now, this is a very early prototype, but what we're going to do is wrap up the REST framework tutorial project using this this wrapper that I wrote, and then we're going to serve it in Functions.
Okay. That's incredible.
So the debugger is up and running. So let's API serverless. Let's hit it. Oh, hang on, is that up and running? Let's have a look. And what I need to look. Okay, localhost, not 1.2. There you are. Always get the wrong URL. There you are.
It
okay.
happens. Happens yeah, it to happens. The
right,
best
now
of us.
this is hit my breakpoint.
So we can awesome.
We can have a look. So what's we're in here, so let's step over this. And let's step into the Azure application. Okay. Let's get rid of this for a second. And what we have here is a Azure request adapter. Mm-hmm. Because Django doesn't take Azure requests.
Right.
It takes WSGI requests. So what we have to do in the adapter is we have to map the Azure request into something that Django understands, which is a WSGI request. So this gives us the environment, which is a dictionary of the parameters in the environment. Then the other thing that a WSGI application needs is a callable that takes the response. It takes the request mm-hmm. header. So when the application is ready to return its data, it calls this start response callable with the headers, basically. And so we get out of this a Django response. Now, if we pull up the debug console, mm-hmm. we can look at this.
Not quite yet. I think you have to step over one
more. Ah, you're right. Yes. Well done. Thank you. I always make that mistake. I hit the breakpoint on the line before it's evaluated. There you are. Ah, no. Now I get the autocomplete. Brilliant. Okay. And it's a Django response. And it's got all the, you know, all the properties of a Django response. It's got the content. What's the content? Well, it's a big, long HTML string, which is the one that's returned by the Django REST framework application
right.
if we want. So let's... let's just put a breakpoint in here, and let's continue. Here, oh well, you know, next stop. So we advance here, and so just before we return the response, we have to map it back to an Azure response.
Right.
So what the Django response is a WSGI response, and what we want is a Functions HTTP response. So here we just map it back, and we get the Azure response, and we map the various. Properties that attributes that it has from features of the Django response, and then we return it.
So here you've implemented this mapper for Django, but it would also be straightforward to implement it for any other Python web framework.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, okay. So the wrapper is a work in progress. It's
yes.
a prototype to can we get Django serving in Functions? Can we get any WSGI application serving in Functions? Well, yes. Here I'm using the Django response, but yeah, we could make it Flask, and then we could make it generic.
Yes.
Whiskey. And that's the goal, you know, as time goes on. So anyway, that's the process. We return the response, and then if we just step up, that response that gets mapped back into a function response is what we return. And so if we just continue.
Yeah, let's take a look at what that looks like.
There's our same application.
There
it's
goes.
The same application we've been using the entire time, but just now it's served in Functions. Now, we can deploy that. We can just click on that, and we can click Deploy to Functions app. But we've already got that up there. There you are. Oh, let's just get the URL right.
Yes.
There you are. Again, the same application we've been using the whole time, but this time deployed in Functions.
That's incredible. Today on Azure Friday, we learned about serverless Django applications on Azure Functions. Carlton, thank you for coming on Azure Friday and teaching us about Django on Azure.